Welcome to Tokyo. A glorious morning here coming up towards noon. Kenny Dalglish in the sunshine here in the Olympic Stadium. And the team news first of all, as we look at Ian Rush, but sadly we shall not be looking at Mark Lawrenson, because Mark Lawrenson, who is such an important part of this defence, has unfortunately failed a test on a hamstring injury, and so he's out of the side, and Gary Gillespie takes his place. Otherwise, it's the team that beat Coventry last Tuesday. Independiente, there's one Uruguayan international in the team, seven Argentine internationals, including the captain, that's Jorge Barruchaga. He's 22 years old. A familiar name there to English fans, Claudio Marangoni, who had a season with Sunderland in 1979. The referee comes from Brazil. It's Romualdo Filho, who's been a FIFA referee for 21 years. A glorious day, as I say, and a crowd of over 62,000 here in the Olympic Stadium. They've paid anything between £5 and £16 for their tickets. Programmes have cost them £3.50, believe it or not, in what really is just about the most expensive city in the world, I think. Well, it's a testing time for Liverpool, certainly without Mark Lawrenson. Bearing in mind that a British side has never won this World Club Championship. And we're just about to get the kickoff then. It'll be Independiente of Argentina in those red shirts and black shorts. They'll be attacking the goal to our left. Liverpool in a change strip of yellow. Craig Johnston getting in very quickly. Morby also. And Johnston downed in the first seconds of the game. Quite a pedigree of Independiente. They've eight times been the Argentine first division champions, seven times they've been the South American champions. It's Johnston again, who admitted before the start that he'd never really been so nervous in his career as he is today. It's an indication, I think, of how much importance Liverpool are putting on this game. They were here in 1981 when they were beaten, almost humiliated in fact, by the Brazilian side Flamengo. They feel then that their attitude wasn't quite right. They're determined that it shall be now. Hansen gets it back to Bruce Grobbelaar. Kennedy. Long ball forward. Dalglish trying to get in behind. Boccini playing it rather awkwardly back into his own defence. And a foul there by Morby, and the Brazilian referee quickly onto it. It's interesting that both sides here will pick up something over £100,000 for playing here. The winners get an extra £25,000, but there is a law also. Dalglish trying to get his way through, stopped by Villaverde, that if there should be misbehaviour on the field, the authorities have the right to dock some of that money. Well, a free kick to Liverpool, and certainly in the opening couple of minutes there have been one or two very harsh tackles indeed. Kennedy hitting it in low, and it's Villaverde, the sweeper, who gets it away. Morby playing it in once more. That was Barruchaga away this time. A throw then to Independiente, who've had a fairly moderate time in the Argentine league this season. About halfway down, process have conceded quite a few goals. It's a good break though with Clausen, but Hansen breaking it up for Liverpool. Got walk on ahead of him. Rush away out on the right, comes through to Rush. Here he is, Morby, Phil Neal, and Morby getting a word from the referee. It looked in the first place as though the Dane was fouled, and maybe there was a slight retaliation. I think Liverpool had the impression that the referee, when they spoke to him yesterday at a reception, he was a fairly fussy character. Marangoni, Phil Neal's header going straight to Barruchaga. Craig Johnston getting it back to the safety of Bruce Grobbelaar. Japanese crowd, who are not known for their expertise on football, they just loved that long kick by Bruce Grobbelaar. There was a great around this huge stadium, which was built, of course, for the 1964 Olympics. Here's Dalglish. Molby. Back for Gillespie. Had about 7 first-team games for Liverpool, but he's only just got over glandular fever. Now Boccini, the real little playmaker, 30 years old. Looked as though there was offside, and indeed it was. Perkudani. Kennedy again for Liverpool. Rush. Back again for Alan Kennedy. Walk was trying to get in there. It was Marangoni's header. Kennedy back to Hansen. Won't be an oriental setting, but I'm sure that in the background you can hear the klaxons, which make it sound like a very European occasion. Svea Verdi. Finding Pecodani, Boccini, and again offside. That time it was the number 11, Barbaron, who is a very, very quick flank player. 5 minutes gone, as you can see. Number six, there is Trocero, the captain. There's Ian Rush with him. Trocero had a period playing in France. That's the real golden boy of South American football at the moment, Uruchaga. Dalglish just getting a little flick on that one towards Rush. Marangoni. It's a curious pitch that Liverpool are playing on here. It's the grass is almost dead. They say here that it's impossible to keep it green because of the climatic conditions. I'm not sufficiently a horticulturist to tell you why, but they play a lot of rugby on this pitch, but very little football. It's Rush. That's a good ball there for Craig Johnston. Now, can he get a cross in? Well, can Phil Neal do it? Dalglish didn't get a touch to that one. It comes back now again to Molby. And an offside on the far side. On Steve Nicol, I think it was. Swift challenge there by Gillespie. And an onside here. And Pecodani with a chance now for Independiente. Something like 7 minutes gone, Independiente go into the lead. And the 19-year-old striker, Perkodani, is the man who gets it. Marangoni's pass. Liverpool thought there was a suspicion of offside there. But there he goes, the number nine. And that's a sad, sad start as Grobbelaar comes out. Independiente into the lead. Slow motion replays from all angles, and none of them bringing much joy to Liverpool, or indeed I imagine to many of you, particularly on Merseyside, who've stayed up all night having special parties hoping that it'll be a night of celebration. At the moment, as you can see there, it's a South American celebration. Now let's see what Liverpool can do about it. Chaga. Puts Gillespie in. Interesting that the pass should have come from Marangoni, who, as I said, had a season with Sunderland and was telling me in training that he loves England and is looking for a chance to get back and play in English football. And as he put it, this match could be my show card. Since he left Sunderland, he's had some 11 Argentine caps. Free kick to Independiente. Gillespie's header. It's fair to say that Independiente have been a little more fortunate with their preparations. They got here at least a couple of days before Liverpool, and it's taken Liverpool some time to get themselves acclimatised and to shrug off the jet lag. There's Gillespie again. None of them have been sleeping very well, they're telling me. They've been ordering eggs and bacon at something like 4:30 in the morning because they simply can't get to sleep. Well, they weren't caught napping there because there was an offside that time by Barbaron. That's the manager we saw briefly there, Mr. Paterizzi of Independiente. Pekadani comes again to Little Chaga. Robilar's out quickly, needs to be, gets there first. Now Kennedy. 10 minutes of the game gone. Independiente leading by 1-0. Dalglish trying to get walk through. Trocero getting it away for Independiente. Comes to Craig Johnston. Touch now for Mulby. Space for Kennedy. Steve Nicol on the far side. And he's halted by the Independiente defence. And here's Boccini. Again, trying to get Barbaron through. And there's a lot of space for him on this left-hand side. But his timing of his runs has not been quite right. Again, he's caught offside. Hansen lugging it through towards Rush. Rosero up well, and Rush apparently fouling the Independiente defender. Three is Enrique, and an early problem then for Joe Fagan. Getting it away. In fact, it was Marangoni who got that one away in the end. Nicol trying to flick it through for Dalglish. Tried again to get it through to Dalglish, and twice Villaverde stopped him. Now in the end it comes once more to Dalglish. Can Rush get in there? No. Mulby. And the pass to Dalglish wasn't nearly good enough. Gudichaga. Oh, delightful skills there. He outwitted Kenny Dalglish superbly. Found himself some space. Boccini. Here come Liverpool again with walk. Just can't get their forward movements going at the moment, and Independiente looking fairly secure at the back. This is the captain, Trocero, finding Boccini. Liverpool throw. And somebody shouting there, saying leave it to me, I think it was, and the referee heard them. And he does, I must say, in these early stages, giving the impression of being a very fussy referee indeed. It's one thing to be firm, but it does rather ruin the game if it becomes a bit too fussy. Walks header, good one, finding Dalglish, a nice touch, but Nicol can't force the ball through to Kennedy. some stadium this. Right in the centre of Tokyo with all its skyscrapers. What a beautiful sight it is. A really busy, restless city this is. Definitely having a word with the linesman. There's something that I'm not entirely happy about. It might well be, in point of fact, it's out of your picture at the moment. I think it's somebody holding a microphone who is wearing a red anorak, and the linesman is saying, I'm getting confused between him and Independiente players. So the microphone carrier down on the touchline has got to take his anorak off. That might go out of play. Indeed it does. It's Phil Neal. You've just joined us. It's Liverpool one goal behind. Scored after some 7 minutes by Perkadani. Chiaverdi getting it away. Boccini. Again trying to time it. And again he's timed it badly. It wasn't Perkadani, it was this fella here. Number 11, Barbaron, who was just fractionally offside. Gillespie playing it through to Rush, coming a little deep. Walk. Marangoni getting it away. Little touch there towards Boccini. And Boccini's feet were too high. It'll be Liverpool's free kick. You can see as Gillespie went in. That's what brought about the free kick to Independiente. Marangoni, another free kick. Gillespie up, putting it well in the air. Comes back conveniently for Walk. It's Kennedy. Struck by Budachago, Perkadani now. Moldy. Avalanche, the president of FIFA, on the left of the picture there. From Brazil, who no doubt be delighted to see the South Americans doing well. In fact, it's not since 1976 have a European side won this particular tournament, and that was Bayern Munich. And Rush obviously feeling he's being hustled unfairly from behind there. He acted fairly strongly. A touch in by Walk, a header away by Villaverde, an important one it was as well. But Ochaga getting it clear, though, as Independiente are in the end stopped by Kenny Dalglish. A look of frustration on Kenny's face. He and Ian Rush are the two Liverpool players that all the Japanese reporters wanted to know about over the last two or three days. Now, Barbaron has made the right sort of run. Struggling a little bit, but in the end it fell favourably for Grobbelaar. Alan Kennedy. Dalglish. Nicol. Molby. Gillespie. And Hansen. the Japanese crowd again as Grobbelaar hits a long ball forward. Dalglish's touch for Craig Johnston. Kenny Dalglish again. He's got Steve Nicol outside him as Liverpool come forward. Now can Nicol whip in a cross? No, and he can't even find Craig Johnston. Steve Nicol, who became a father a few days ago, a little boy, Michael, I think had a bad night last night with a sore throat. Here's Marangoni. Rush. Mulvey. Ooh, hitting it straight to the Argentinian though. Walk. Johnston. Long ball there, finding Nicol. A nicely guided header in for Dalglish. Certainly having enough of the play, but at the moment not putting anything really worthwhile coming forward, Liverpool. And now they've lost it again to Bocini, with Buruchaga going away on the right. Hansen. Kennedy. Now towards John Walk, and a fraction too high for him. It'll be an Independiente throw. 20 minutes gone. Liverpool 0, Independiente 1. Enrique with the throw. Now it'll be a Liverpool throw. Phil Neal with it, releasing Mulvey. Joe Fagan was certainly hopeful that Mulvey's skill would really be seen to good value on this rather difficult pitch. Thought he might be the surprise trump card for Liverpool. The referee wanting the free kick taken where he wants it to be taken. Showing scant regard, the Brazilian referee at the moment, for keeping the game moving. Bocini, little touch getting it back from Buruchaga. Bocini again for Marangoni. So they are putting a nice little move together now as Bocini back again for Marangoni. But hitting it straight at Phil Neal. That wasn't a particularly good header by Neal. And Pecodani. Bocini again. Enrique. So the fullback trying to get a forward play going until Steve Nicol comes in, and it'll be an Independiente throw. Marangoni's header. Enrique into touch. Johnston to Dalglish. Little flick for Mulvey. Hansen. Now Nicol. Kennedy. Kennedy again, this time for Dalglish. Nicol just keeping it in. And Liverpool get a corner. Dalglish floating the corner in, and they almost got it through. In point of fact, it was Craig Johnston who was uppermost in that 6-yard area of Independiente's, but in the end the Argentines get it away. It'll be a throw to Liverpool. Phil Neal with it. Japanese crowd enjoyed that overhead kick, but brought a brief respite for Independiente, and an offside against Walk. Top scorer for Liverpool with 11. Fractionally offside here. Another Liverpool free kick. Mulvey, Dalglish, nicely into the path of Alan Kennedy. It's Villaverde getting it away. Hansen, Dalglish, a little flick on. Enrique. Barbaron quickly closed down by Phil Neal. And now Ian Rush. Daniel Kuss. Dalglish almost got it in. And they were in trouble there for a moment, were Independiente, as Rush and Dalglish very, very nearly fashioned an equaliser for Liverpool. And even when Dalglish didn't really get the touch, Aaron Goni, who was right in there, could so easily have been in trouble. And the end, it's behind for the corner. Craig Johnston will take a deep one again. Poison, the goalkeeper, the Uruguayan, catching it quite comfortably. Hansen's header. Well, that will give Liverpool a little bit of heart. It was so close there to the equaliser for them, with about 25 minutes gone. Independiente leading by the goal by Per Cudani after 7. Steve Nicol. Liverpool, in fact, have brought the bare 16 players, 11 plus 5 substitutes, and now with Lawrenson out of action, it means, of course, they're down to 4 substitutes. 2 allowed. Dalglish. And that'll be another Liverpool corner. This is a better score for Liverpool. Number 4, there is Clausen, the right back. It'll be Kenny Dalglish who will float the corner in, and they brought Gary Gillespie forward to use his height. Ian Rush is on the goal line. Here's the corner floating in towards Gillespie, but it was too high for him. Trocero got it away. Mulvey. Well, he was penalised there for a foul, which looked a little harsh, I must say. Chaga trying to get Barbaron away, but Grobbelaar and Hansen between them surely will hold him off, as indeed they do, at the expense of a throw. A 25-year-old, Alejandro Barbaron. Pochini really got to keep him at bay. Cudani, and the feet too high. Now this could be a problem. Now Trocero is the king of the free kicks. It may be him or it may be Barruchaga who take it, but it's Trocero in fact who's got the ball at the moment, as we see again a replay of the incident. Now he is absolute dynamite from free kicks. Barruchaga's there too, and Marangoni. Moment of crisis, but the shot was a fierce one, but it was charged down, and a great save from Clausen. He struck it superbly, and a brilliant piece of keeping by Grobbelaar kept it out. There's the original free kick that was blocked by Mulvey, and what about that? What a brilliant shot, and what a superb save. Still 1-0 to Independiente. And here they come again. Chaga, Pochini. for Uchaga. Captain of his country, but not of his club. Gillespie. Rush. Marangoni. Ooh, that's a fair ball there by Marangoni, but once again, Bartwell is caught offside. Slightly frustrated. Little flick on there by Kenny Dalglish towards Walk. Independiente's throw. Walk. Hitting it towards Rush, but far too close to poison. Clausen. Uchaga, Marangoni, Larson again. A throw to Independiente. Free kick to Liverpool, a foul on Ian Rush, and I suppose Ian must have known when he came here that the attention on him would be very close indeed, and that's the way it's proved to be. Fairly bruising early afternoon for him so far. Dalglish with the chest down there. It's Hansen right in there that time. Won't come out as far as Johnston though, but here's Neil. Mulvey. Liverpool still looking hard for this equaliser. A goal down after 7 minutes by Pierre Cardani. Boccini tried one trick too many, and another free kick. Dalglish. Just get the impression that Liverpool are beginning now to put one or two things together. Mulvey. That's a better ball there for Craig Johnston. And whipped in well, and the keeper did well. And that's the best looking move for Liverpool so far, apart from the moment when Rush and Dalglish very nearly brought about an equaliser. Lovely ball out to Craig Johnston, and what a whipped in centre that was. Clausen, the right back. In goes Kennedy. One by Hansen. Now here's Nicol. Hansen. And back to Grobbelaar.
It's lovely to hear the oohs of the crowd every time Bruce hits the ball, one of those long ones into the Argentine half. That time it was a free kick for the foul on Dalglish. So Phil Neal will take it. Walker Nicol at the far post. Dalglish and Rush in there. Rush is almost being wrestled there by Trocero. And the free kick given, presumably for a bit of shoving by Liverpool. Neal with the throw. Gillespie. Hanson. Rush to Mulby. Gain to Craig Johnston. Getting a bit of freedom out there on the right. And trying to get past Enrique into the side netting goal. In this game in 1981, I'm not at all sure. That wasn't his first game for Liverpool. Uruchaga. But dwelt on it far too long, and Walk was at him. And again, it's a free kick. I'm bound to say, I hate criticising referees, but this is so much stop and start. I think certainly the style of so many British referees, where they do like to play an advantage, accept that there's a little bit of bodily contact in the game, but at least keep it moving as a spectacle, which I'm sad to say at the moment this Brazilian referee doesn't seem capable of doing. But now let's see if there's some movement coming up from Steve Nicol. Dalglish is stopped. Orcini trying to get the ball back to Buruchaga, but bit of composure on the ball there from Gillespie. Now Neal. Kennedy. Certainly getting enough of the play, Liverpool. But Kennedy, I don't think we'll get to that. That's a goal kick. A bit of British influence in this Independiente side. The red shirts that they wear are apparently a tribute to Nottingham Forest, who went on a tour of Argentina back in the early 1920s and made such a favourable impression that Independiente took their colours and have worn red ever since. They, in fact, won the toss to wear red. Liverpool then had to wear their change strip of yellow. Gillespie, who's in for Mark Lawrenson, if you've just joined us, who's injured. Stopping it well there, but it's a throw to Independiente. Something like 6 minutes to go to half-time. Walk, nice turn, found himself a bit of space. Dalglish trying to set something up for Craig Johnston. Good play by Enrique for Independiente. And a pass that goes out of play before Barbaron can get to it. Independiente still leading by that early goal from Pecadani. A bit of skill there by the fullback. Here's Kennedy. Dalglish just onside. Biaveri right close to him. Now Mulby. Good raking shots, and you're always likely to get an awkward bounce on a pitch like this, and Boysen knew that he had to get right behind it from the Dane shot. after Dalglish had played it nicely into his path. I think it probably would have gone wide. And while this is happening, there's a threat for a moment at the other end, but stopped by Gillespie. Independiente's throw. Enrique crossing it in. And Kennedy was bowled over there by the number eight, Giusti. Free kick. Or is it a goal kick? It's a goal kick. Five minutes to half-time. Independiente leading by a goal to nil. But here's Mulvey.
Just getting it over to Steve Nicol. And who looked to be badly impeded there, I would have thought, but the referee has turned a blind eye to that. As Clausen is off the field just for the moment, having taken a tumble there.
Certainly looked as though Nicol, as he was aiming to get a cross in, that he was very badly impeded by the Argentine defender. Kennedy showing just a little too much of that to Giusti. Nicol again, very active in this period of the game, Steve Nicol, and here he is again, getting a ball in early, this time to walk.
Just needed to cross that in. Now can Dalglish do something with it here? It might come for Craig Johnston to fire one in. Save. Mulvey firing one in. Liverpool claiming a handball there, as Kenny Dalglish was. But that was a very promising break there. And Mulvey shown the yellow card for something he said to the referee. And it'll be a free kick to Independiente. Johnston, who had a really blistering shot there, and Rush also heavily involved. Oh, that was a bright moment for Liverpool coming towards half-time. Pastorizza, the Independiente manager.
Craig Johnston. Bit of space ahead of Ian Rush now. Nicol. Still with Nicol. Nice bit of skill there. The Japanese crowd enjoyed that, and surely a free kick now. Well, he was clattered to the ground there. Mulvey finds himself with a yellow card for something he said, but for the tackling that's going on, so far not one word of warning from the referee. Now let's see what Liverpool can do with this. Kennedy and Dalglish on the far side there. It's Dalglish curling it in, and Goizon happy to push it over. Making that little decoy move, but it's Dalglish's shot that produces the corner, and it'll be Kenny Dalglish with it. A little chip in again there, but Barbaron getting it away to Boccini, and now for Percadani, the man who scored the only goal of this half, but he's up there on his own with five Liverpool players around him. Oh, what skill there, but in the end he was stopped by Hansen. Uchaga to Boccini, good breakout this by Independiente, but Phil Neal getting it back. Oh my word, for a moment I thought he put it past Kovalov. Trocero misjudging the bounce there. Oh, what a shame, the referee didn't play an advantage there, but he allowed at least Kenny Dalglish to take the free kick quickly, and it's with Steve Nicol. This is a better spell for Liverpool without any doubt at all. They've come much stronger in the second period of this half, but there's still a goal down. foul apparently by Gillespie. A free kick to Independiente. On Giusti, the number 8. He's got a birthday coming up on Tuesday when he'll be 28. Has made a good break, but Phil Neal's head is there reliably for Liverpool. John Wart finding him. Apart from the goal, they've really only had one good strike of Independiente, beautifully saved by Bruce Grobbelaar. And Liverpool, if anything, have had more of the play, but still find themselves this goal down. And an offside against Barbaron. The flag was a little late coming up, to be fair. Phil Neal. Alan Hansen. And that's the half-time whistle. Liverpool find themselves at goal down by this 19-year-old Jose Percudani after 7 minutes, a good break. But Liverpool thought for a moment he may have been offside, and as Grobbelaar came out, sadly, that was the finishing touch. And so at half-time, it's Liverpool 0, Independiente 1. Independiente, in fact, are a multi-sports organisation. They play some 40 sports with 50,000 members. And those 50,000 members will be hoping, you can be sure, as they watch live in Argentina, that Ian Rush isn't going to nullify the goal by Percudani in the first half. It's been lovely to see all these Japanese children here, and they've, I think, probably enjoyed some of the touches of Kenny Dalglish as well. But I can tell you they've also enjoyed the special lunches they've brought with them as well, because looking at them before the start, they were going away hammer and tongs with the chopsticks and having a thoroughly good time. And then Hansen, he's been troubled a little bit by this jack lag problem that I've talked about. Joe Fagan was saying that he and Kenny Dalglish are two players who do love to get as much sleep as they possibly can, and that's something that has evaded Liverpool since they arrived. And Norby on the left, just going out of the picture there, he was telling me the same sort of thing. Phil Neal. Jan Mulby, I must say, the Dane, speaking to him now, he's getting very quickly a good Scouser accent. Well, here come Independiente. Puduchaga, their hero, but not the goal scorer, because Percudani is the man who's got the only goal, here he is, of that first half. And they also will start the second half without any of their substitutes on. Boccini, a playmaker from the midfield. They say that he was the childhood idol of a gentleman called Maradona. So now we start the second half with Liverpool attacking the goal to the left now. A goal down, seeking to become the first British side to win this World Club Championship for the Toyota Cup, and the first European side since Bayern Munich won it in 1976. But we've work to do, this goal down. And an offside straight away against Percudani. Free kick to Liverpool just inside their own half. They certainly pushed their defenders forward for the whole of this first half. Hansen with it. Floated towards Rush. Too high for him. Kennedy tried to come in, but it was a little bit too rash of a challenge there by Alan Kennedy. But Johnston finding Hansen. And a long chase is on. Hansen's long leg stretching out, getting there before Percudani. Dalglish. Inside, but Norby getting it on now. Can Craig Johnston get there? And for a moment, They were in a little bit of trouble, Marangoni, as he was hustled there by Ian Rush. And Joe Faden at half-time, obviously wanting Liverpool to keep the momentum going that they found just before half-time. Well, the keeper didn't get anywhere near that one. And it's going to be another throw. A bright start to the second half for Liverpool. Not a good long throw there, but Kennedy, can he get it onto the left boot? He can, but not enough power on it. And a deflection there that takes it behind for the corner to Liverpool. So Rush going into the six-yard area. It's a good long throw. And Kennedy's shot coming off Marangoni. And Dalglish now with the corner for Liverpool. Right at the start of this second half, and a safe and a simple catch for the keeper. Uduchaga. Hansen, good clean header. Hansen, nice steady pass this time to Craig Johnston, going past Marangoni. Independiente's throw, which Enrique will take. Giusti. Trocero, man who played in the French First Division for Nantes. Gillespie's touch, a good one as well. Finding Phil Neal, back to Gary Gillespie, who's in, of course, for Mark Lawrenson, who failed that fitness test earlier this morning for a hamstring. And certainly, you have to say, in no way has Gary Gillespie let Liverpool down. Here's Boccini, the 30-year-old. He and Marangoni, the stalwarts and the oldest players in this Independiente side. Good work by Kennedy, just keeping it in. All good work by Alan Kennedy. Bit of applause there from the Japanese crowd, they enjoyed that. Rush, but that pass will fall straight to Enrique. Might get it onto the left foot for a shot, but no, stopped by Hansen. And a shot by Giusti high over for the goal kick. Craig Johnston, Independiente's throw. With some nice control there by Kenny Dalglish. Now, can he set something up for Liverpool? It's with Rush. But in the end, he couldn't quite get it through to Steve Nicol. Kekadani. Giusti. It's a determination about Liverpool at the start of this second half. Marangoni. Long ball onto the far side to Barbaron. Hansen in first. Molby also. Craig Johnston battling away. But the ball comes to Marangoni for Independiente, trying to get Percadani away once again, just as he did in the first half. And Liverpool doing their utmost to keep it out, and in the end there was a foul by Percadani, free kick on Gillespie. Nicol, the space for him down the left. He's got past his man. Got past Giusti. He's got past Clausen. He's crossed in, and Trocero, as Goyson came down for it, could easily have sliced that much closer to his own goal.
In the end, it's a corner, quickly taken by Dalglish as you're watching this replay. And in the end, it's Boccini who gets it away, but there was quite a little flurry from that corner in the Independiente goal. Goal kick. Steve Nicol went in. Marangoni, Trocero, the captain, Clausen. Ball for Giusti, Uruchaga, Trocero, Uruchaga. And we saw Craig Johnston off there, but Craig came back to try and get it back once more, but it's still in the possession of Independiente as Boccini now gets Barber on away. He's got Uruchaga in the middle. Oh, and what a hash he made of that. But for all that, it's a throw. Good break by him, but the cross really wasn't of any quality at all. A lot of pace about him. Good battling there of Craig Johnston. Did really well there for Liverpool. Sets a really good example. And there's Watt getting in with a good header above Marangoni, who stands at 6'3". But it was Trocero getting it away this time to Barbaron. Phil Neal is there with him. Independiente still leading by a goal to nil. Bottini coming in, but here's Gillespie. Neat interception. A little touch there for Molby. And here are Liverpool again. But no, given away once more. Uruchaga. Now Clausen. Cross is in. Gillespie gets it away to Craig Johnston. Much pacier start to this second half. Walk, Molby, now Nicol, Dalglish, and Rush are up ahead of him. There's Kenny Dalglish. Oh, he's played that nicely for Craig Johnston, who couldn't control it. Walk getting it through nonetheless to Phil Neal, and now for Craig Johnston again. It calls for a good cross. It'll come towards Steve Nicol. There's his header, but again, no great problem for Independiente. Uruchaga. Boccini. Giusti outside him. Uruchaga making the break. And a well-timed one as well. Crossed it in, but against Gary Gillespie's legs. Behind for the Independiente corner. 10 minutes of the second half gone. Independiente still leading 1-0. Boccini, half stopped by Kennedy. Little flick for Uruchaga. Stopped by Neal. Independiente's throw. Giusti with it. Turned by Uruchaga. He's got something to do to beat the Liverpool players there, but in the end, it was an apparent foul by Steve Nicol. And again, it could be a problem. As I told you in the first half, Trocero and Uruchaga are experts with this free kick. One from this sort of position in the first half eventually needed a brilliant save from Bruce Grobbelaar. Now let's see who has a go at this one. Trocero driving it, deflected off the wall, was it? For the corner. Well, to the... there's total confusion out there at the moment as to whether it's a corner or a goal kick. In the end, it's quite rightly given as a corner, and indeed it was Enzo Trocero
who hit that powerful free kick against the Liverpool wall. Buruchaga. Little touch again for Boccini. Enrique. Getting to that byline, but again, not a good cross. A Liverpool goal kick. That's Carlos Enrique, who's 21 on Wednesday. A little bit crazy, the Argentinian journalists say. And in fact, he has been sent off once or twice in his first-class career. But the behaviour overall has been pretty good in this game, I have to say. Kennedy. Rush. Boccini. Playing it on for Barbaron. Pepperdani's in the middle, and here's Boccini. Chance of a shot at goal, which spun away from him. The man who scored the winner in this competition, in fact, Riccardo Boccini, in 1973 for Independiente against Juventus in a match in Naples. But way off the target there. Out quickly to get the ball back into play. That's the Independiente bench. The manager, in fact, had a mild heart attack earlier in the year. Such is the stress of managing a football club, I suppose, but happily he now seems to have made a complete recovery. That's Clausen with the throw for Independiente. Touch on by Trocero, a clearance by Gillespie. Enrique. Boccini. In comes Mulby. And now Dalglish. And now Jan Mulby. Rush is in the middle, and so is Walk. Dalglish is offering a bit of support. Good play here by Jan Mulby. The little flick in, and it's Steve Nicol on his way, and a good save. Good play by Liverpool. An excellent play by Jan Mulby. It's some really fine play here by the Dane. And Buruchaga at the other end with the cross. And a goal kick. Dalglish. Nice turn by Kenny Dalglish there, but they had two whacks at him, but didn't deter him. But the throw now going to Independiente with 15 minutes of the second half gone, and Independiente leading by 1-0. Dalglish, oh, Mulby took a whack there, I think, after he played that ball. He suddenly started to hobble very badly. Kennedy's long crossfield ball cleared by Enrique to Barbaron. Neil doing very well indeed. Now Johnston on for Walk. Now for Craig Johnston. Good cross coming in for Liverpool. Rush is there, and so is the keeper. Kennedy. Gillespie getting it back for Hansen. Neil making himself available. Hansen once more. Oh, momentary lack of concentration there by Alan Kennedy. for Uchaga now. Finding Giusti. Hansen in very quickly indeed. Doing well for Liverpool. Kennedy hitting it towards Rush, but he was fractionally offside. You get the feeling that an equalising goal is well within the compass of Liverpool. This one goal down, scored by Perkudani early in the first half. Dalglish. It's a little chip ball there for Nicol. He's done some good work down this left for Liverpool. Support coming up from Alan Kennedy. Mulvey, who's really beginning to blossom too in this second half for Liverpool. Nicol. Well, that looked to me like an obstruction, but alarmingly, he's given a free kick to Independiente, apparently for some pulling back by Steve Nicol. Oh, would you have given a free kick to Independiente there? Giusti shoving off Dalglish. The throw given to the South Americans. One linesman from Japan and one from South Korea. The referee from Brazil. Uruchaga. Marangoni. And an offside against Barbaron for the umpteenth time in this game. Free kick. Mulvey. Now Craig Johnston. And Barbaron just happy to bang that away into touch. Liverpool's throw. Johnston with it. Here's Neil. Hit in towards Rush. Dalglish right there with him. The little chip through. Walk is offside. Sadly for Liverpool, it won't count. The flag was up. The whistle had gone. As Dalglish played it in, given against John Walk there. On the right, Michael Robinson in the picture. And there's Joe Fagan, of course. Side Uruchaga. I suppose it's a bit of a dilemma really for Joe Fagan as to whether to think about a substitute. The fact is that his side are not so far behind in any sense Independiente at this moment. I get the feeling that an equaliser could be snatched. Oh dear, Hansen losing out badly there, but then getting it back from Boccini. Walk. Oh, and a back pass, and it came to Uruchaga, and Grubelaar, brilliant, saved Phil Neal's blushes there, and the anger on the goalkeeper's face there, because that put him in real trouble, and the athleticism of Bruce Grubelaar prevented a second goal for Independiente. And all in deliberate one there. No action from the referee, and Rod Stewart wondering whether some of his Scottish friends like Kenny Dalglish or John Walk or Steve Nicol maybe can get an equaliser for Liverpool. Phil Neal with the free kick. Hey. you've got any sense about you, you never bet against Liverpool in this sort of situation. They're still 25 minutes to go. They are just a solitary goal down. And to repeat one of Brian Clough's best loved sayings, it only takes a second to score a goal. Hansen playing it in. Warp not quite getting the touch. Rush not getting the shot in. Johnston can't either. But Rush gets it back again. Gets it to Nicol. Plenty of red shirts are back, and that surely was obstruction again on Nicol. But again, the referee says play on as Hansen gets it back to Grobbelaar. The ball is difficult to control, there's no doubt about it. A fairly unpredictable pitch. And Walk not quite able to get on the end of that long through ball. But there's obviously a big Liverpool faction in this crowd. They are willing Liverpool on to search out this equaliser. Aaron Goni's header was a strange one. Dalglish taking it up. And here's Nicol again. A nasty bobble just as he was about to strike it. You've got to have a bit of sympathy with him for that. In fact, Joe Fagan was saying in England the pitch very often controls the ball for you. On a pitch like this, it's the players who've got to do it. It was a funny old header by Marangoni, and Dalglish gets it on, and just as he was about to strike it, there was that little bobble that sent it over the bar. So tough on Steve Nicol, who certainly had a very good game here. You could just see that on the up as he made contact. This is a good spell again, but another deliberate handball. That's two. And another free kick. Phil Neal will take it. I notice that the Argentinians are warming up a substitute, Reynoso. But at the moment, Phil Neal. And a safe catch by the keeper, Boyce. Albi. Nicol. Dalglish. Here comes Nicol again. Well, you can understand Steve Nicol's aggravation, because that's a couple of times in the last two or three minutes where it appears to me, at any rate, he has been obstructed, but both times the free kick's been given the other way. In fact, it's Monzon they're looking to bring on now, who's a defender. Maybe they are slightly fearful that Liverpool are looking much more dangerous in this second half. But at the moment, it's Independiente on the ball. Once again, it's Dalglish. Trocero, as Walk came at him. Craig Johnston winning a valuable header. Trocero getting it away again. The referee trying to get in on the act there. And now, away come Argentina again. Boccini. Cardoni with a little bit of pace there, but a good shoulder challenge that almost sends the Independiente player into the crowd. And a lovely ball that finds Craig Johnston. This is better stuff by Liverpool, but they're so desperate looking for this equaliser. They've upped the tempo, and they've made themselves look that much more dangerous. Their attitude has been absolutely right for this one. Craig Johnston going in, looking again to make something of it, but the ball just wouldn't break his way. Boccini. A slip by Molby, but a strong challenge. Caraja finding Boccini, but again it's Liverpool. Nicol. Gurruchaga again. Giusti. It's with Gillespie.
A little under 20 minutes left. Nicol. Had nearly all this second half, Liverpool. Still a goal down. Foul on rush by Clausen. And Clausen is going to get a yellow card. Added to the one that Jan Molby got in the first half. They've turned up the volume on the klaxon as Kennedy put it in, and Walk was right in there, but high over the bar. But suddenly Walk and Gary Gillespie, who'd come forward quickly, were in a really dangerous position on that far side, as you can see. Two of them making the break, and it's Walk who got it on the half volley and couldn't keep it down. Certainly got free of his marker. Johnston. Rush. Trocero away. Gillespie. Rush. Johnston. Towards Nicol. Won it in the air. They're under a bit of pressure now, Independiente. And a free kick given to the Argentinians. Percadani has got clear. He's got Barbaron up there with him. Still with Percadani, but no trouble for Gobolov. Bolby. Kennedy. Liverpool warming up. Ronnie Whelan, I think it is, down there. And they are going to bring on Monzon, Independiente, number 13. Boccini turning it on, Barbaron's after it, might get clear, Percadani in the middle, Barbaron! Okay, the fight is over, and Grobbelaar looks well in control. Nicol. Mulby trying to search out Walk, but it was Marangoni's header. Foul there on Percadani by Hansen. A free kick to Independiente. And they're going to take off their number two, Villaverde. So Monzon is on. And Ronnie Whelan is stripping off for Liverpool, so he'll be on very shortly. Barbaron. Well, Gillespie was fooled there for a moment, but Steve Nicol gets it back safely to Bruce Grobbelaar. So you can see, with a quarter of an hour to go, the game is still very well balanced, except Liverpool are just this one goal behind, but having much more of the game in the second half. Independiente's free kick. You can see there Ronnie Whelan about to come on, and it looks as though it's going to be John Walk they're going to take off. It certainly won't be Ian Rush when they're looking for goals. But they've got a free kick, Liverpool. Phil Neal will take it. Quarter of an hour left. A goal badly wanted. Walk getting in with a header. Trocero, the captain for Independiente, getting it into touch under pressure from Kenny Dalglish. So the substitution about to be made. Ronnie Whelan is on. Swapping a midfielder for a midfielder. Ronnie has scored four goals this season. Now there couldn't be a better time to make it five. Put Achaga's header away.
Boccini well beaten in the air, though. Nicol to rush. Kennedy really busying themselves, Liverpool, but they just can't seem to be able to forge that one opening that can be so important. It's Independiente's throw. Ooh, well, whose feet were high there? Six of one, half dozen the other, it seemed to me. The free kick has gone to Independiente. Trocero. Phil Neal backpedaling under pressure from Barbaron, but he gets it back quite safely. Gillespie, Whelan, his first touch is a fairly negative one, back to the keeper. Gurney with some good skill, but an offside against Percadani. There's a slice clearance there by Gillespie. The flag is up. The referee either hasn't noticed it or has ignored it. Gillespie again. A safe ball, this one, to Alan Kennedy. Trying to release Steve Nicol. It's out of play. It's a throw. Rush beaten in the air by Monzon, the substitutes. Another free kick to Independiente. It's number 8, Gisti. Now it's Enrique who's apparently in a bit of trouble there. Maybe we should get a clue as to what it was there. Well, I can't think what he was holding his head for, can you? Unless maybe it was to waste a little bit of time. Well, here's Kennedy. They might have some defending to do now. Flick on again by Kenny Dalglish towards Rush. First time we've seen Bruce Grobbelaar outside the penalty area. Hansen. Dalglish. Neal's pass going straight to Percadani. Pedicciaga, Boccini. And again, frustration there from Craig Johnson, who thought he'd made a fair challenge on Boccini, but the whistle's gone for the free kick. Pedicciaga from a long way out, and he hit it from a long way out because he'd noticed that Grobbelaar was away. Well, some 7 or 8 yards off his line. But there was plenty of time for Grobbelaar to get back. And the ball with Phil Neal now for Liverpool. Neal again. Dalglish. Getting across here now for Kennedy. As Liverpool comes streaming forward again. Whelan's little touch. Falling straight to the keeper. Inside the last 10 minutes. Boccini, Marangoni, Boccini. Another free kick. Must have been that Gillespie caught his man in the face. Boccini was a winner in 1973. He's about 9 minutes away from being a winner in 1984. Now they hit free kicks from a long way out. Trocero, but he would need to hit them a lot better than that. Look at that rank of cameramen behind Bruce Grobbelaar's goal. There are as many at the other side and behind both flanks at the other end as well. Enrique caught off balance there. Molby. Kennedy.
Might come in for Rush, who is being almost wrestled to the ground there. But again, it's Rush who is alleged to be the guilty man. This will be quite interesting to see.
Now, how is Ian Rush doing the wrestling there? It's a free kick given to Independiente. Gillespie caught off balance, but fortunately for him, straight back to Bruce Grobbelaar. Arangoni hitting it straight at Kennedy. Trocero gets it back. Hansen. Giusti. Beaten by Johnston. Handball there by Enrique, who claims it hit him on the chest. The ball's in play. It's with Craig Johnston. Stop Barber on there with a good, strong and fair challenge. Enrique finding Puruchaga. Marangoni. Pecadani. Independiente's throw. Well, I wonder if it's this young man's goal. He's just 19, but will win the World Club Championship for Independiente. They have a little over 5 minutes left to hang on. Boccini. Independiente's throw. Remember, there's an extra £25,000 to the team that wins. Both sides getting something over £100,000 for the right to compete here. Another free kick to Independiente. Puruchaga behind it. Trocero, who so often takes them, I thought for a moment was staying back, but now they've decided to bring him forward. So will there be work for Grobbelaar here? He played it in short to Boccini and Liverpool get it away. Marangoni hitting it back once more, no trouble there for Grobbelaar. A long ball, but sadly for Liverpool, hit straight into touch. That was not what Grobbelaar intended. He intended to try and reach Rush right up front. We're inside the last 5 minutes now. Craig Johnston getting it forward. It's with Rush. It's with Dalglish. With Nicol going up outside. Molby alongside him. Plenty of yellow shirts up now, joined by Kennedy. As Liverpool look for something late in this game to save it, still with Kennedy, with no power in that shot. And the keeper carefully behind it, not wanting any mistake now. Some good, strong play here by Kennedy, but sadly for him, after the good play, the final shot wasn't good enough. Nicol not wanting any help from Marangoni to get up. He's taken a clump on the side of the head there, I think. Yeah, that was a rather nasty challenge from behind. A free kick given quite properly by the Brazilian referee. Kennedy hitting it towards Rush. Got the header in that time. And just as Steve Nicol was lining up a shot, the foul on Giusti was enough to provide them with a free kick. It's going to be Clausen with the throw then for Independiente. Time for Liverpool now to make that last dash, but there's a free kick given against Kenny Dalglish, Burruchaga, and another free kick given against Liverpool. No, it's this time it's in their favour. It's with Kennedy. It's with Steve Nicol, little dummy that gave him a yard. On now for Ronnie Whelan, who's had so little chance since he came on, but he gets a free kick now for Liverpool. Well, can they yet save it as we come to the last 2 minutes of the game? Alan Kennedy with the free kick. Played in for Kenny Dalglish. On again for Alan Kennedy. And another throw. Now, who will it be? Someone who hurls a long throw, maybe into that Independiente penalty area. Steve Nicol playing it short, in fact, to Kenny Dalglish. And it was a foul throw. Well, a resigned look on the face of Kenny Dalglish. Thinks that not much has gone Liverpool's way. Shake of the head. A throw then to Independiente with just over a minute left. Phil Neal, Alan Hansen, hitting it forward again, looking for a mistake, but not from Trocero, the Independiente captain. Boccini, a foul on him by Craig Johnson, a free kick to the Argentinians. And Marangoni plays an extravagant back pass to his keeper, more than half the length of the field. Come through to Grobbelaar. If Liverpool are going to save it, it's got to be saved quickly for Joe Fagan now. Boccini. Again, it looks as though the South Americans are going to take this championship. The ball out of play, a Liverpool throw. This is, of course, the first major sporting contest between a team from Britain and one Argentina since the problems in the Falklands. It's gone off sportingly, but it's gone off with the final whistle, sadly, in defeat for Liverpool. The goal by Per Cudani so early in the first half has meant that Liverpool have come halfway around the world only to go home a beaten side. That happened in 1981, but certainly today they've given a much better account of themselves. But the smiles and the congratulations come from the Argentinians as Liverpool troop off the ground back to their dressing rooms. Monzon, who came on as a substitute. Marangoni, who said, "I want to play in England, and this can be my show card." Well, I wonder if anybody has spotted him. There's his pass that came through for Pekadani right at the start of the game, and as Grobbelaar came out, that was the agonising moment for Liverpool. They felt there was maybe just a question of offside, but it was really marginal. And that was the moment that really...